Cummer was a truck manufacturer in the UK from 1905 to 1979. The intent at origin was to build all varieties of industrial vehicles. They were generally a lorry producer, but did eventually produce smaller vehicles. A small pickup, an express delivery van that looked about the size of a large station wagon. Speaking of station wagons, they also produced the Cummer Cobb, which was a station wagon. They produced an imp van, which looked like a Chevy Corvair with a small cargo box on the back. This particular casting is a Cummer BF, which was a purpose-built vehicle, ironically often used as ice cream canteen. The Matchbox 47B was just such a truck. If it looks familiar, I did a rent-a-cent van that used the same face. To their credit, Lesney often did this, and also used this on a Nestle step van. Lesney started producing it in 1963. It was always blue, almost. The last year they produced a number of cream versions with a slightly different decal. This one was produced before 1966. I know that because the base was a snap-in, which dates it prior to that. They came with a few different detailing layouts, but grill, headlight, and bumper were the most common. You know I love my restorations. If you do too, stick around. Those oldies but goodies reminds me of you. The songs of the past bring back memories of you. I always will remember the first night we met. The songs they were playing I never will. You know, one question I get asked a lot is why I don't file on these castings when I'm doing a restoration. I guess it's because to me, a restoration means to take back to its original state. The original toy had the casting lines. If I am to restore it, then they need to be there. I'll use primer to help fill in the nicks that come with years of play, but my hypocrisy only extends so far.
Dedicate one to the ladies. Summertime sip, babe, need something to keep you cool. Ah, now summertime sip, babe, need something to keep you cool. Better look out now, though. Dave's got something for you. Tell you what it is. I'm your ice cream man. Stop me when I'm passing by. Oh my, my, I'm your ice cream man. Stop me when I'm passing by. See, now all my flavors are guaranteed to satisfy. Hold on a second, baby. I gotta put my banana Dixie cups, all flavors and push-ups too. I'm your ice cream man, baby. Stop me when I'm passing by. See, now all my flavors are guaranteed to satisfy. Hold on one more. Well, I'm usually passing by just about 11 o'clock. I never stop. I'm usually passing by just around 11 o'clock. And if you let me cool you one time, you'll be my regular stop. All right, boys. eyes. I put my banana Dixie cups on flavors and push up to her ice cream man. Stop me when I'm about to survive. See, now all my flavors are guaranteed to satisfy.
So there you have it, the Matchbox number 47B, Commer Ice Cream Canteen. I think of all the 1 to 75 castings, this one has to be just about the ugliest. I was so curious as to the color that I did a search for the real McCoy and found a company called Mr. Tasty that used blue Commer canteens. But, and this is a big but, they were only blue on the bottom. The majority of the top was white, and I can also tell you that irrespective of what ice cream company it was, this was common. White or cream top color and a color on the bottom. I had to buy glass for this, and I don't recall where I got it, but it fit properly, so I'm pretty sure I know where I didn't get it. The little guy had since lost his ice cream cone. I contemplated putting a Trump sign in his hand. But that hand is smaller than the lead in an average number 2 pencil, and I'm glad that the whole arm was not gone, especially since a one-armed ice cream guy would make for some messed up cones, yes? The decals came from Black Square. Those guys are the best. There will be an episode of The Bench after the video, and it's November, so I'll be giving up a casting. This is Time Rider, and I'll leave the light on for you. Thanks for hanging around for this episode of The Bench. November 28th, Three Blind Mice, Aston Martin 177 build. And if you don't see your name, sliding up the screen right about now, you should head over to the Three Blind Mice channel and let us know. You can also email us at threeblindmicediecast, all one word, at gmail.com. Come and join the fun. I'm done with my challenger for Mopar Monday. I'll announce the winners Monday of last Monday's castings, and we'll have a couple more to give away this Monday. Speaking of which, make a comment below that says, "Gimme Rockets, man." And next Saturday, I'll announce the winner of this Rocket Man truck. The Coyote would be so proud. This one is a mashup I did, and yes, the cargo container is screwed down. The paint is Tamiya clear red over duplicolored silver base. All of my castings are forcibly split open and no longer fit for play by children. Parts have been removed and reattached and could pose a choking hazard if swallowed. These castings are intended for display purposes only. I've told you that November's always a busy time for me. I had a birthday. My channel started 2 years ago. The Three Blind Mice did their first community build. And 2 years ago, actually, on October 31st, but who's counting? Anyway, I was told that I was no longer going to have a job. I took a picture of the place that I called home for 3 decades. I experienced tragedy, saw awful things, and dealt with really awful people sometimes. But I also knew happiness, great success, respect among my peers, and some of the best people that I've ever encountered. Это моя дома. How's that for a Russian connection? I hope you enjoyed the video and it finds you healthy, happy, and wise.